Hey guys, it's me Karen, and I would like to make a makeup video for you today because I really enjoy doing my makeup lately. And I've just a window here. I hope the light is okay, but I think natural light is the best. Anyways, I have been on an appointment in town with some colleagues, and I didn't have much time, and I was wearing a bold lip, a Bordeaux kind of lip, and then I went to the Douglas store. In Germany it's like similar to Sephora, and they put, I wanted to try a liquid shadow, but the one that they put on me, it doesn't look good because it's something from YSL, but it's just has a lot of glitter in it, and I don't like glitter. And also I didn't even put concealer on my eyelid, so first we're gonna get rid of the little makeup that I've got going on. And I used to do this with the Douglas Essentials Sensory Makeup Remover Oil. Sensory makeup. But I kind of, I don't really have one method to remove my makeup. I kind of do it in different methods. This is the Bioderma Makeup Removing Micellar Water Solution. Not water. And I'll just put this on my cotton pads. Just put it on your mascara and get rid of it by just touching the ink very lightly, very gently. I know it always looks a little harsher than it is in a video, but I don't always remove my makeup like this because you need a lot of solution, a lot of pads. So I recently bought the, what's it called again? I didn't even put a foundation on today. But I have a little bit of powder on. I bought the Clinique Take the Day Off. Cleansing balm. But I must say, I don't think it's ideal. Because it's kind of need a lot, and it's just a little expensive in my opinion. It was like, I think I paid 23 euro or something. Must be 27 dollars maybe. US dollars. And I like to do any treatment and cleansing and skincare on the neck and as well, and also on the hands if I can. So now that the face is clean, we'll take another product from Bioderma, and it's the toner for sensitive skin. And we'll just need some little drops. I have my mirror here, so if I look down there, you know why. For my German viewers, that I recently bought this facial and hand cleaner, which comes in a foam from Rossmann, and it's for babies. So it doesn't have that sodium lauryl sulfate that most cleansers have. And I also sometimes use just one of these cloths. It's just a microfiber cloth that you can wash. And just this in water gets rid of almost anything that is soluble with water. So I use different types of cleansing. And I must say I've tried the Sephora cleansing oil, but I don't like it as much as the Douglas one, because the Douglas one, it has these emollients, I think that they are called, and you can just wash it off with water. And I think that the Sephora one, it just, the skin remains oily, so you can't really wash everything off, and I don't like that. So now for skincare, I've bought the very expensive Shiseido eye serum, which I want to use now. It is, I wouldn't buy this again, because it has a lot of dimethicone in it, and that's basically a silicone oil, so it feels amazing, but that's about it. And I was kind of offended about what they write in that little packing. Notes. I don't know. They just claim that. I can't remember what's in there, but something like emotional stuff. That like, like the product can soothe. Like when we have emotional stress, and that's kind of like, come on. It's none of your business. And I'm taking this Fair Organic Vegan I+M Hydro Perform Serum Hydro Effective. So this is with aloe vera and hyaluronic acid. Glides on very easily. You can already see why I'm enjoying makeup so much, because I have these really dark circles and I tend to have some red spots also. So it's fun to cover everything up and pretend like we don't look as fatigued. Okay, now for some cream. And I'm using the La Roche-Posay Tolerian Soothing Protective Skincare as moisturizer. And I will mix in something with it. It's the Diadermin Lift Plus Vitalizing Vitamin C Booster. Put my cream here. It says a little gummy. Okay. And I'll just mix these in. It's a very light, very watery moisturizer. I should have wrapped my hair up. I'm just going to skip the SPF today, but it's very important. I never go out without it. And actually yesterday I forgot, but that was a first. And I usually use the La Roche-Posay. And you can get this at pharmacies in Germany. And this is a new product, especially for the eye region also. I just use it all over my face. And then we'll let the skin sit for a little bit. Maybe put on a lip moisturizer. This one. Now I'd like to put on my eyebrows. This is precisely my brow. Benefit. I always find it a little bit frustrating that I couldn't find a product that I can draw on individual brow hairs with, but I don't mind anymore. I mean, the artificial hairs that you draw on. I don't know, it's probably not even looking that great. So I always try to make the eyebrows thicker than they are. I actually found a picture of myself from childhood in which I had much thicker eyebrows. But as I'm already 37, I was still in that, like, was in the 90s. I was a teenager in the 90s. So, therefore, I plucked out my eyebrows to make them thinner. That was just the way that I wanted them to look back then. Because my sister did it, my older sister. And you know what I mean. So that's about the way that I like them nowadays. So now let's show you my secret weapon against these circles, and it's La Roche-Posay once again. It's this color correcting pen. You just squeeze it up, and you put a terribly yellowy color on there. And then you just pat it in, and it magically disappears. And your dark circles magically aren't all that dark anymore. Sometimes, when I really don't have time to do any makeup, I'm glad it's not that often that that happens, because I also enjoy it, but then I just, this is very necessary to have this plexiglass, acrylic glass part here. I can't even remember where I got this from, but I just saw it one day and thought, oh, I'll use this for a foundation. And I use it every day. So I will mix in different foundations. First, it's this Superstay from Maybelline 24-hour full coverage foundation. Then we have this L'Oreal Perfect Match. We'll also take the Trend It Up 2-in-1 Camo Makeup and Concealer with the glow effect. Even read that. And I have the spatula. And I'll just mix them all in. Makeup sponge with my MAC Fix Plus. It's just a setting spray that's very liquidy, so many people use it to wet their makeup sponge also, which I also like to do. And then I'll take some, instead of cosmetic wipes, I'm just taking plain toilet paper, because I'm using so many and it's ridiculous keep. Why those makeup wipes? So I'm just taking this. And covering up. Face. Just beating my face. Don't worry, I'm also going to apply some more concealer. And as Jeffree Star says, covering up our insecurities. I've actually never. I never used to do my makeup this way. I've only learned this in the last couple of months. I kind of started last year, this obsession. Makeup. Because wanted to cover up those dark circles, and then I did that, and I noticed that the under eye area looked pretty crepey, like crinkly. Some ladies in the store what to do, and they said I need to use an eye cream. Oh, actually I forgot to use an eye cream. Anyways, now for some concealer, and this is the All About Eyes concealer from Clinique. These are the old ones. They have brought out some new kind of concealers and pushed the others out. Not sure if I approve of that. And then I'll take the Maybelline one. This is a very known. And I've just removed the little sponge because it was really messy. It still looks messy right now. And I'll just mix these two together. Then apply some with the spatula. On the dark circle area. Now I'm taking a tiny little beauty sponge. And you wet those sponges so that they don't soak in all the product. We also apply this all over the lid so that the eyelid is prepped for eyeshadows. Looks really strange now, but just trust the process. I think I look extra red. It shines through because I am talking, with an imaginary viewer as you. And when I talk, I need to click. I'm producing myself. And I kind of tend to get very red when I talk to a lot of people, or I have to explain myself, right? I just fetched some water. So, as you see, I have just the structure that the dark circles are not only dark, but they are... There are these caves, and they produce a shadow there. So, if I have a lot of time, I will also use this Make a Factory. Concealer, light reflecting concealer. Just has this little thing here. And I'll only use this right where the form produces the shadow. Gently tap that in. It stays in place. You can tell me if this is any better, or if I should skip that altogether. Yeah, it's probably nonsense. But anyway, so now we have to fix all these concealers in place. And I have the NYX Mineral Set It and Don't Fret It for that purpose. Just take this rather small brush. Great. I have some powder on my dress. It's very important that you tap the area right before you put the powder on. So, on that, there's no creasing. If you have problems with that area, go and watch the video from Maria Gentle Whispering about it. She has the matte fixing spray from NYX. She used it to set her under eye. I've tried it and it kind of works, but only if you use very little. And I'm also using this to set the foundation, especially in the T-zone, where I tend to get I can get a little oily. So now for the fun part, I'm gonna take my favorite bronzer, and I know everybody has this. I have the little mini version, and it's the Hoola bronzer. bronzer from Benefit. It's a cult classic. And it's actually really good. So now that the face looks really flat, because all this foundation, I'm gonna give it back some color. And you apply this just on the high points where the sun would fall. It also makes the face look a little slimmer. Sorry. And you can also try contour a little bit with it. Just so that it looks a little bit slimmer. So I also like to use, firstly I'm going to take the Ultimate Shadow Palette from NYX with Warm Neutrals, and I'm going to take Application Luxe Soft Definer Brush 227 from Zoeva. I'll take this shade for the whole lid. Just so the other shades can blend in. And now we'll take the Hoola bronzer actually and create a little dome shaped crease area. The secret to this is to go over, like when you have a hooded eye, like me, you take it over there, so you let the hood recede back a little bit. I usually do these little rounded motions. You can always, for a more editorial masculine look, you can also take the color a little bit up there to make the nose look a little smaller and everything a little more fierce. Okay. So now let's deepen this thing up a little bit. Which shade do we use? Let's go for this one. I'll just take the same brush. Did I say this one or this one? I think it's this one. Yeah. A little much. I'll just tip it off here a little bit. And I'll take this mostly towards the outer corner. To deepen the effect. There's a lot of blending to be done. I like it to look I'll take it on lower eye, lower side also. And this creates a much larger looking eye. Oh, great. I just painted my eyeball. Sorry about the funny faces. So now let's also put on some blush. Art Deco container. Chosen this 30D blush. It's just a powder blush, and I'm taking this to apply my blush to make the face look more alive. Crazy on camera, but in reality it looks okay, I believe. Okay. Oh yes, while we're at it, I have also this cream kind of highlighter, also from Art Deco, and it is 12C. And I've tried lots and lots of highlighters to put on a already powdered face, and this was the only one, at least in that drugstore that I went to, that looked, oh my god, looks crazy in the monitor. That just looked elegant. A little more natural. Okay, so now we can go on with the eyeshadow. And I want to use this Catrice The Glow Mineral Highlighter Powder. Brush. And I'll just take a good amount, place it in the inner corner, the eye. Wow, this is crazy. I thought like that makeup doesn't show up as much on camera as it does in real life. But it seems that some things really show up and some things really don't. Fascinating. So, what now? I think we're still not done with the eyeshadow. Let's do even more. And we'll take this dark color. And for this, I'm taking a smaller Zoeva brush. Looks Petite Crease. And I'll just deepen the outer corner. Looks crazy on camera. It's so funny that it looks very different on camera than it does in real life. Always have to look in the monitor. Like I tried it way out. Maybe I did. kind of create a shape that goes up like this. I think I'm pretty happy. So now for eyeliner. I have an eyeliner from Makeup Factory. Can't even read the name right. And I'll try to just do a little wing. We'll see how little or big it's going to be. And the trick is for the wing to look into a mirror that's not magnifying and look at it, look down to it, and so then you can mark where it's somehow easier to see where the tail of the eyeliner has to go, the wing. With the hardest part. So that's pretty okay for me. To me. I've seen that some YouTubers do their eyeliner with that they try to fix it or make it more matte by applying a black eyeshadow over it. I don't know, I don't do that. I think the eyeliner on its own is okay. Now I have to look which direction I want the wing to go. I've just marked the point. Here. It's just the most, you need the most concentration for this part, of course. That's why you'll never find a YouTuber talking whilst doing this. You just need to remember to breathe. Okay. Well, that's pretty okay so far. Oh, and I forgot I wanted to... Oh, I'll just let the mirror be here. I forgot to use some highlighter on the brow bone. So I'll take the same highlighter. Actually, I'll take another one. This is also from Art Deco, like the cream one that I showed you. It's the most wanted highlighting palette, and the lightest color is the one that actually shows up on my skin. The darkest one on the right doesn't show up whatsoever. Not at all. And yeah, people sometimes also do this business, putting it on the Cupid's bow. I will usually take fan brush. It's a little much. I guess we're ready to curl the eyelash. I think it's always... Oh, I just noticed that I forgot to put any primer in my face again, like in my last video, so never mind. I'm taking the L'Oreal Paradise Ecstatic. It's by far the best mascara that I've used so far, but it dries out really fast. So as a cheap alternative, it's also quite expensive with 12 euro. Where is it? Where is it? Can't see it, but the Princess Lash from... Where is it? Oh, that Essence does the same job. Almost. So, curling my lashes. You have to be careful not to squeeze in your skin and these little parts, right? Just pushing them up and you can already see a difference, right? Fast. Now you have to be fast. And coat them. And not put the mascara up there like I just did. Because then you have to wait and scratch it off later. So this is already pretty dry, this mascara. So I have to put in a lot of effort to coat these babies. But yeah, I'll probably throw this away soon. It's seen better days. But like when you buy it new, it lengthens, it thickens, and it separates perfectly. So that's awesome. I have too many things here. You've all been well. I'm playing The Elder Scrolls Online. Quite a lot. But hey, it's still better than smoking, right? This is a kind of addiction that will go away in a few weeks. And I don't know. I hope so, because it's taking a lot of my time. Yeah, but it's fun. As you will have seen if you looked on my social media. So now I'm taking... These are sticking. I'm taking a little silicone comb to get them separated again and to get these standing up, not be so clumpy. Now I can get rid of little things. I could just scratch away the mascara. And we can correct a little bit here and there. And where the line is as shitty as I just did it, I usually take a cotton swab and some pore filling primer, or any primer, to erase, basically. Black eyeshadow right on the eyeliner. Oh, and then you can kind of smudge the edge a little bit. Doesn't work. Anyways. Makeup fail. Now for the lips. I think I'll go with this lilac. Kind of. Lipstick, and let's see if I have a lip liner that's similar. Maybe this. Hardly, but I'll try. Try to make them work together. Usually don't use lip liners too much. Probably just laziness. And that is that. Or maybe. A little more to create a little bit of a shape. I think I like the combination. Not ideal, but good enough. And then doing this business old school. So now we're pretty much done, but we need another Fix Plus round, and I like to drench my face in this stuff. So this was dry, and this kind of pulls all the layers together, pulls all the makeup layers, puts the powders down. Pulls them down into the whole look. And I kind of should be more contoured maybe, but I don't know. It can look artificial, and we're already done, so I have a little bit of a cheeky, big cheeks, and maybe I should cut the hair more so that it comes in my hair contour. So about the hair, this was once supposed to be balayage. But it all washed out, and now it's basically, yeah, it has a softer color change, but it still doesn't look very balayage-y. And then I made the mistake of putting some blue short time dye in it, like on some parts, and it ended up looking green for quite some weeks. First it looked blue, then it looked green, and now it's kind of grayish. And I actually wanted to put something like a light brown over everything, but I didn't dare because I'm not a professional and I didn't want to, I don't know, experiment. But I'm a little bit like, kind of like this hair, but I don't know, what do you think? So, shall we end this with a little bit of face tickling? So I hope you liked my little get ready with me. I think I'm going to visit my mom later. And maybe get her to watch some Good Wife. Oh, I also lately watched The Horror from AMC, I think, and it was an awesome show, very uncommercial, amazing cast. I watched it on Amazon Prime. It's a drama slash horror series about Illuminati confirmed, about the search for the North Passage. In the 19th century, in the middle of the 19th. And it's based on real events, which are really fascinating because no one really knows what happened to all these men who died out there in the cold. But some of the findings were really mysterious. And if you read up on the real story and then watch it, it's even cooler in my opinion. But it's as astounding as it is, I think it's not a series to binge watch. I usually love to binge watch, especially the good show. The better, the bingier was my motto. Not really. And this one, it's just too heavy. It's just very heavy material. It can be quite depressing. And so you cannot watch more than one episode. So that's my recommendation of the day. And I hope you're really well. Thank you so much for watching my video. Always makes my day when you comment and subscribe to me, or do both. And I hope to see you soon. And I hope you can relax well tonight. Still there? Okay, let's pop a little color on, shall we? Because I have another one. The Brights from NYX. And I was just thinking, what did I do on the boring look? Let's try some orange. The fallout. The fallout. Wow, and also the kickback in the palette. It's tremendous. Heard that it's really hard to make. Oh, let's try the lighter green. To make green pop. So forgot to tight line. This is an Art Deco eyeliner waterproof tin. And this just gives the appearance of dense